हेलो क्लास 10th, वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर 1, द यूनियन पार्लियामेंट. टुडेज टॉपिक इज रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द टू हाउसेस ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट. वी विल डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडेज टॉपिक इज डिफरेंस ओवर द लेजिस्लेटिव मैटर्स, कंट्रोल ओवर द एग्जीक्यूटिव, इम्पीचमेंट, elections of the president and the vice president, functions in respect of subjects included in the state list, emergency provisions, special or exclusive powers of Rajya Sabha, special or exclusive powers of the Lok Sabha, or difference list of subjects for legislation. Now we will discuss some keywords. First word, rebellion. It means revolt. Number 2, draft. It means order. Number 3, oblige. It means compel. Number 4, enactments. Means implementation. Number 5, deadlock. It means standstill. Relationship between the two houses of the parliament, or points of difference between the two houses of the parliament. Theoretically speaking, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha enjoy equal powers, but we cannot overlook the fact that the Lok Sabha represents the people and is elected by the people. On the other hand, the Rajya Sabha represents the states of the Indian Union, and its members are elected indirectly by the members of the state legislative assemblies. They never have to go to the people. In such a situation, it is but natural that the Lok Sabha is given a clear upper hand in almost all matters concerning the parliament. We shall discuss their relations as under. The Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha are the two houses of the parliament. The Lok Sabha is known as the lower house of the parliament, while the Rajya Sabha is the upper house of the parliament. These two houses of the Indian Parliament differ in terms of their nature, power, processes and functions. Difference over the legislative matters. Legislative enactments, enactment means implementation, belong to two categories, ordinary bills and money bills. Ordinary bills. An ordinary bill can originate in either house of the Parliament and must be passed by both the houses of the parliament before going for the president's assent. But in case of a deadlock, deadlock means standstill between the two houses over a bill, it is to be resolved in a joint session of the house with the speaker of the Lok Sabha in the chair. As the membership of the Lok Sabha is more than double the membership of the Rajya Sabha, it is the will of the Lok Sabha that prevails on the strength of its majority in the joint session. Legislative enactments belong to two categories, ordinary bills, money bills. Ordinary bills. Any member may introduce an ordinary bill. It can be introduced either in the Lok Sabha or in the Rajya Sabha. Once the bill is passed in one house, after their readings, it goes to the other house. If the second house wants to change the bill, it may send to the house where it originated. If there is any deadlock over the ordinary bill, it can be resolved by the joint sitting of both houses of the parliament. Since Lok Sabha has more members as compared to Rajya Sabha, therefore its influence prevails. Money bills. In case of money bills, the Rajya Sabha has been given virtually no powers. Firstly, a money bill can originate only in the Lok Sabha. Secondly, when any money bill is passed by the Lok Sabha, the Rajya Sabha has no power whatsoever to make a change in it against the will of the Lok Sabha. It can at the most delay a money bill by sitting over it for 14 days. After the expiry of the period, the bill is supposed to be passed by the Rajya Sabha and can be sent for the president's signature. A money bill has to be introduced in the Lok Sabha. Then it is transmitted to Rajya Sabha for its recommendations. Rajya Sabha has no power to make a change in it against the will of the Lok Sabha. The Rajya Sabha has to return the bill with recommendations in 14 days. However, the Lok Sabha can reject all or some of the recommendations. Difference between a bill and an act. A bill is the draft. Draft means order of a legislative proposal which, when passed by both houses of parliament and assented by the president, becomes an act. Bills may be either money bill or ordinary bills. Act. Act is a law proposed by the parliament. Bill is a draft of proposed law that is presented to the parliament. Act is called a bill before it is approved by the parliament. Bill becomes an act after it is approved by the parliament. Act can create a new law or change an existing law, whereas bill can propose a new law or change an existing law. It is difficult to change an act once it is implemented. A bill can be changed easily compared to act. Control over the executive. The Union Parliament exercises its control over the Union Government in a number of ways already discussed in this chapter. Both the houses of the Parliament have equal rights of asking questions, of bringing in various kinds of motions against the government. But here again, the Lok Sabha has the real say. The Council of Ministers is primarily responsible to the Lok Sabha. A vote of no confidence passed in the Rajya Sabha does not compel the government to resign, but a similar vote passed in the Lok Sabha makes it obligatory for the government to quit. As we have already discussed in our previous video about the parliament exercises its control over the Union Government, both the houses have equal rights of asking questions, but again here Lok Sabha is more powerful as Council of Ministers are responsible to Lok Sabha. If the no confidence motion passed in Lok Sabha, then the entire government has to resign. But it is not in case of Rajya Sabha. Impeachment. Impeachment means challenge. In matters of impeachment of the President of India or the Chief Justice or a judge of the Supreme Court or of High Courts, both houses have absolutely equal powers. Impeachment can be initiated in either house and the other house has an equal say in the judgment. Both the houses of the parliament have equal powers in matter of impeachment of the President of India, Chief Justice of India and judges of the Supreme Court and of High Court. Elections of the President and the Vice President. Every elected members of the parliament stands on equal footing in the election of the president or the vice president of India. But taken collectively, the Lok Sabha has a greater say in this matter on the strength of its numbers. President and vice president are elected by an electoral college consisting of elected members of the both houses of parliament, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. But here again, Lok Sabha is much powerful as their strength is more than that of Rajya Sabha. Functions in respect of the subjects included in the state list. The Rajya Sabha has been given undivided powers in this regard. It is only the Rajya Sabha which can declare that a particular subject of the state list has assumed national importance and that it should be included in the union list. If the Rajya Sabha passes any of the subject of the state list under 2/3 majority of the present and eligible voters of the house declaring the subjects to have national importance on that subject, Parliament acquires the power to legislate, that is to make laws. Emergency provisions. In case of proclamation means order of a national emergency due to foreign aggression or a threat thereof or due to armed rebellion means revolt or a civil war or a threat thereof, if the Lok Sabha is dissolved, It is the Rajya Sabha which shoulders all the responsibilities of the Union Legislature. In case of declaration of the national emergency due to threat, war, etc., and if the Lok Sabha is dissolved, it is the Rajya Sabha who will take all the responsibilities of Union Legislature as it is a permanent house. Special or exclusive powers of the Rajya Sabha. The Rajya Sabha can declare any of the subjects in the state list to be a subject of national interest and thereby empower the Union Parliament to legislate on that subject. The Rajya Sabha can decide by 2/3 majority to set up a new All India Service. Rajya Sabha is a permanent body and is not subject to dissolution. Hence, its role becomes very important during the period when the Lok Sabha remains dissolved, especially during proclamation of emergency. Then it acts as Union Legislature. The Rajya Sabha may be a resolution adopted by 2/3 majority, empower the parliament should make laws with respect to a matter in the state list. It may declare the creation of new All India Services in the nation's interest. If the Lok Sabha is dissolved before or after the declaration of a national emergency, the Rajya Sabha takes over the functions of the parliament as it is a permanent body. Special or exclusive powers of the Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha has certain special powers which make it more powerful than the Rajya Sabha. These are: a motion of no confidence against the Union government can only be introduced and passed in the Lok Sabha. If such a motion is passed by a majority, the Prime Minister and his Council of Ministers resign collectively. Thus, Lok Sabha exercises direct control over the Union Executive. No such power is vested in the Rajya Sabha. There are certain powers which are constitutionally granted to the Lok Sabha and not to the Rajya Sabha. The Council of Ministers are only responsible to the Lok Sabha, and hence the confidence and the no confidence motion can be introduced in this house only. Money bills can only be introduced in the Lok Sabha. After being passed in the Lok Sabha, it is sent to the Rajya Sabha, which can at the most delay it for 14 days. After the expiry of the period, it is deemed to have been passed by the Rajya Sabha. In case of a money bill, the Rajya Sabha has only the right to make recommendations and the Lok Sabha may or may not accept the recommendations. Also, a money bill must be passed by the upper house within a period of 14 days. This, the Lok Sabha enjoys exclusive legislative jurisdiction over the money bills. In the event of a deadlock between the two houses, in case of an ordinary bill, a joint sitting is held. The will of the Lok Sabha prevails. In such a case, on account of its superior strength, the Lok Sabha has 545 members, whereas the Rajya Sabha has only 245 members. As we know that the ordinary bill can be introduced either in the Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha. If there is any deadlock over the ordinary bill, it can be resolved by the joint sitting of the both houses of the parliament. Since Lok Sabha has more members as compared to Rajya Sabha, therefore its influence prevails. Different list of subjects for legislation. The different subjects for legislation have been divided into three lists: the Union List, State List and the Concurrent List. The Union List has 97 important subjects like defense, currency, railways, etc., on which only the center can legislate. In the Concurrent List, about 47 subjects are included. On these subjects, both the center and the state can legislate. But in case of any clash, the law passed by the center shall prevail. On the 61 subjects mentioned in the state list, normally the state and not the center is empowered to legislate. But here too, in certain circumstances, the parliament can legislate on matters mentioned in the state list. Moreover, the residuary powers or subject not mentioned in the above three list also lie with the center. We have already discussed about the different list of subjects for legislature in our previous topic also. The legislative powers are divided into three lists: union list, state list and concurrent list. Union list consists subjects of national importance, presently 97 items, in which Parliament has exclusive power to legislate. State list consists subject of local importance and is 61 in number. Here state legislature has exclusive powers on legislation, but on certain circumstances Parliament can also make laws on these subjects. Concurrent list consists of 47 subjects in which both Parliament and state government can make laws. If two laws conflict, then union law will prevail over the state. Residuary powers, it is not mentioned in the above three list. It also lies with the center. Thank you.